Alright, so I'm starting the broadcast of episode 2. I'm not redoing one because that took way too much time. But apparently I did not enable mic recording, so you guys didn't hear any of that. So this is me returning with episode 2 with apparently no commentary on episode 1 like I was going to have. But this should work. Otherwise, this is all mute.
Previous episode of Life is Strange.
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No!
He called film little pieces
of
time.
What the fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything. Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower. Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again.
Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now. Drink up. It's got electrolytes. Good morning, Lisa. Your leaves are lovely today. I may not have a green thumb, but I have a green finger. No smiling. Take your power seriously. Some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games. It will be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games.
Let's just hope that didn't mute the game earlier. Ugh.
Courtney, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it. Consider it done.
That wasn't rude.
Ow!
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Gross. The Vortex Club are such pigs. I'm glad I pissed them off. I didn't think Kate was like this. Acting on those bros. We shouldn't be watching this. Everybody's seen it by now.
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of The October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up, and you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
Snappy.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Water is almost as good as a cup of strong tea when I'm in sleepy mode. The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Hello? Water?
Sorry. I forgot. Oops. I forgot about the water pressure. No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. I have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book. Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed. Oh shit, Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. Better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine. Meanwhile, my guitar gently sleeps. Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time. Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do...
That's not strange.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like, no time has passed.
You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
So, why would you go?
Lapse of sanity? I just thought I could meet some new people.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Did you go?
Definitely not. I'm not sure where I went.
What do you remember about that?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and right.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here, near my bag. So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Yes, you should definitely go to the police, Kate. I totally believe every word you say. Nathan Prescott is truly dangerous.
Bless you, Max. I will go to the police, and also Principal Wells. With you as my backup witness, they'll have to take us seriously now.
Backup witness? Well, I mean, I believe you in everything, but we're still just spoiled punk students to the cops and faculty. I just think we need to be very careful here.
Why? Careful of what?
Nothing. Except the Prescotts are a powerful family. I hope this won't backfire on us, that's all. Even though that rich bastard has earned some serious bad karma. He'll get it. Time out, Max. You actually told Kate to go to the police and the principal.
after getting a scary text threat. Now the police will definitely drag you into this shit.
Well, it's better that than making her more upset.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive. Good lord. This must be Kate's H.R. Geiger period. Ouch. She left out Amnation. That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes. Kate really has a doting father. That's a lot of tears. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella. Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself?
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor.
Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny.
Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends, too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
The birds are flocking around Samuel. Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me. Like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
Max, check it out.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
By the way, thank you for stepping in. You were pretty badass, Warren. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
Just a pirate I used to know.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
I busted him in a bathroom yesterday with a gun. I'll give you the story later. Principal Wells is taking care of it now, I hope.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
sunlight and you'll be alright. Catch some light and you'll be alright. For now. Crossing so long, heavy on your shoulders. The sirens inside you. Cast some light and you'll be alright. Cast some light and you'll be alright. Crossing so long.
Don't try to take it from me. It's mine.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same. Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
Smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again.
And there she is, a lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man. No matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. It was very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. My karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why. I mean...
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
I did. And I am sorry. I don't want Chloe in any more trouble. Or me.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I... like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell. David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
I saw him arguing with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
I was dreaming about your bacon omelet.
Now finish your coffee. One bacon omelet for the young lady, stat.
Bacon at 12 o'clock, huh?
Nerd graffiti. I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a bar.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty. Stick with bacon.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment. The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
Incoming!
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl. Woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want...
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Your car keys.
Duh, wait. I need details. Describe my keychain.
I don't know.
Do you have some kind of power or not? Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
Nothing. 80. Parking ticket for 10:34 in the morning.
You got this, Max. Now rewind and blow Chloe's mind. This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time! Amazeballs! I literally just got chills. You have powers!
Take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments, so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops!
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh! Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick!
Don't slap me, bitch! Take your fight club outside!
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That's the best song I've heard.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
I'm going to predict 4 events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency. His partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh,
really?
Go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love.
You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox?
I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy! The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave. I wouldn't last one day as a trucker. Those rigs are too damn big.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and what to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too.
Hey Kate, what's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate, I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument.
Is this a race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you, and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized?
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Are you kidding? After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. It freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes, but not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Stupid bottle. Maybe I can use this to reach the bottle. Hello, bottle number one. 4 more to go. So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now. Boom. Only 3 bottles left. I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars. Wowzer. That looks exactly like the same doe from my tornado vision. That doe is the perfect photo op. Three down, 2 more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here. One more bottle to go.
And another message. Let's just hope that was enough to attempt to change the ending of this episode.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Voila. Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road?
You're serious about this.
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Thanks.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool!
Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Max, where do I aim?
Aim slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max.
Ricochet. Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tech.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like, never. So I want one more uber-cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot. Well, Max?
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max! Freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay, looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble? Oh, boo-hoo, Max is afraid. I know you can handle this, and I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey. It's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough. What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please, step back.
You're kidding. Put that down. Come on, girly. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me. Wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now. Nope, I don't want to. Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a time out from here.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer, where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
No, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I don't know anymore. My brain is so fried from all this. I need a mental enema.
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Why? I bet she would hate me.
You're not that different. She had... has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect. Definitely use this bad.
Come on, Max!
Shit, I can't budget at all. Score. I can pull a total MacGyver.
The train's coming! Max, please!
Awesome, it's not locked.
Max, get me out of here!
Which wire to cut? Now that's the right thing.
You okay? You saved me again. Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life.
Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
I don't see how. It's so friggin' random.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
That snow was so insane. Seriously. Hello, climate change.
Max, can we talk? I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
No, it belonged to a friend of mine. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab. Miss Grant is so cool and smart. She defines the word teacher. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug. Weird science. Big brain thing.
Hey, Warren. Are you
Maxwell Silverhammer.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing. She blinded me with science.
Bring me the brain, Igor.
This can't be that hard.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max. It's too bad you didn't sign the petition. Every signature counts, and yours might be the one that decided.
How's your campaign going?
It's missing somebody who should care. But no finger pointing here, Max. More people would rather send a text than sign a petition. That's how they keep us all distracted. Nobody will notice cameras on every square foot.
Some of us want to use our cameras for good.
But people like David Madsen want to use them to spy.
Jeez, I'm not like him, Miss Grant.
I know, Max. But the trick is to make sure Blackwell Academy does not end up like him.
Miss Grant, can I ask you a possibly dumb science question?
You know my stock teacher answer. There are dumb questions. Ask away.
Would you add potassium or sodium to a chemical mix for this week's experiment?
Neither, unless you want a face full of powder. I would add chlorine.
I'm just thinking about all the autumn photos I want to take.
Oh, this is my favorite time of year. I do love the season change. This whole campus is a visual delight. I know Mr. Jefferson loves to shoot around here.
You must like photography.
I do, but I'm certainly no artist. I'm all about the science. You can't debate numbers. I have to say, it's not quite autumn enough yet.
What about that snow yesterday? What's your scientific explanation?
Our climate is moving beyond explanation. Of course, some of the tribes here might see it different.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Yes! That was a blast! But let's keep it a professional secret. Cool?
Hey, Warren.
Maxwell Silverhammer.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
Have that either.
Wrong, Warren. You need to add chlorine, not potassium or sodium.
Chlorine? I didn't think of that. Can't argue with a confident scientist. Let's try it. Eureka! She's got it.
No, you got it.
Don't be so modest, Dr. Caulfield.
Oh, you guys really broke the bounds of science.
That was fun helping Warren. He's pretty cute when he's in full-on geek mode.
Check out the big brain on Max. You might be the next Heisenberg of Blackwell.
So you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine. Nobody does. Nobody. Just leave me alone.
Oh my.
What do you want from me?
She's going that way. Well, don't know where that petition is at.
I just don't want Kate Marsh to be the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
Not exactly. Never mind. Sorry. I have to go and work on my photo.
You can talk to me anytime. And Max, can I talk to you about Kate? I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
That's rather screwed.
No. I just don't want Kate Marsh to be the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
That was a private conversation. Not that I wouldn't tell you.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Make me beautiful, Hayden. Bo.
Dina. What's up, Daniel? Out
of control. Waiting to drop Dana left, after Hayden gets right. His paparazzi
show
on.
Me the love.
How do I look, Taylor? You look like ass.
That's a great sketch of Dana. Daniel is the real deal.
Waiting to drop Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
It's hard to not like Hayden because he just doesn't give a shit.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm
no
sure.
No time to talk, Max.
To the
art in progress.
Like I give a flying fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson like he gives a shit.
Like anybody does. Max is such a little...
Shh, I think she can hear us.
Better be quiet, Victoria. We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
You would know. Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max, so I won't forget you.
Assholes. Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
down.
We have a lot to cover today and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
Not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false information. images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. Usually, people need something to judge, so they never take a good look at themselves.
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson published his own little book of photo tips.
We can thank Rea... reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in monochrome.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay, okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
You matter, and not just to me.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help, like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
I'll always be here for you, Kate. My new motto is, friends come first.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel feel like you really listen. Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning, I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror. Are you serious? Thank you so much. The fact that you don't care about that video and would come up here to stop me means a lot. I care about you because I believe you were drugged. We will find out who did this and make them pay. You sound so persuasive, Max. If only... Kate, I believe you. Will you believe me? Please, you don't have to do this. Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything. Nobody cares, Kate. There'll be another viral Victoria video in a day, and everybody will forget. You can't scrub my video from the internet. And that's how I'll be remembered. Unless I jump. Kate, you can't do this to all the people who care about you. No. Nobody cares about me. Nobody. What about your mother, Kate? You'll destroy her. She doesn't care about a video. She loves you. You don't know my mother at all. She already thinks Satan has me on the fast track to hell. Let's prove it. No!
Shit.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us, but we have to go over what happened before Miss Marsh, before she did what she did. Officer Barry will be taking notes for the official police inquiry. I'm sure you'll give him your full cooperation.
Such a tragedy.
But there must be a reason for everything. We need to find out why Kate Marsh would be driven to such desperate action. As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Coffey, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
I saw Mr. Jefferson talking to Kate right before our class. Then she ran off crying.
Mark, I do know that Miss Marsh has assisted you on class events.
Kate, Miss Marsh has been very withdrawn lately. I assume this awful video was the cause. I hated seeing the students laugh at her. She told me Max was the only one who believed her, would take her calls and actually listen to her.
She shouldn't have asked to be on video, macking with some dudes.
You ass! She didn't ask for any of this.
No, on the contrary. Max was right to bring this up. Now, I wanted to help, but I guess I was too late.
Well, now this is problematic. The publicity is rising, and perhaps You shouldn't represent Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes contest in San Francisco.
Are you serious?
I am. We don't need any negative press about that event. And we need to involve the Academy in possible disciplinary measures for you.
I understand. There are bigger things at stake than me. The life of a young girl, for one.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
I just can't believe it. It's like it wasn't even real. Watching her drop like a weight, I really thought I could save her. Like a superhero.
Come on, Max. Do not for a second blame yourself. Kate was on that roof for her reasons, not yours.
My hand just reached out.
Stop it. You were the only one with balls enough to run to the roof. You were the only one who cared.
Yeah, I sure made a big fucking difference. Maybe if more people cared, better people than me.
You're the best person around.
Warren, I screwed up today.
That makes no logical sense.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren. I believe anything this week.
Well, this being the end of episode 2, I'll be putting this up on my YouTube channel right after I finish this broadcast, and yeah. I'll add in a description somewhere about some other thoughts I've been having on this episode.